Hi, this is Pastor Rick. I'm glad you're joining me today. You know, it's the Christmas season, and all of us are so busy with many things during these holidays. And yet, it's important for us to remember the reason why we have a day called Christmas. Christmas is a day we remember that Jesus Christ came to earth. He was born as a baby and grew up to be our Savior. And the reason he came is because God loves you and loves me. And he gave his son. The most precious gift that you and I can ever receive is the Son of God, Jesus Christ. The story in the Bible is told in Luke chapter 2. It reads this way. Now in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that a census be taken of all the inhabited earth. This was the first census taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone was on his way to register for the census, each to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, in order to register along with Mary, who was engaged to him and was with child. While they were there, the days were completed for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. It was a very busy time in the cities of Israel when Jesus Christ was born. People were all traveling on the roads to go from city to city and to get back to register in the place of their family's lineage. And having come to Bethlehem, the inn was full. Bethlehem at that time was only about a 1,600 population, so it was a small town, probably a small inn, and there wasn't any room, can you believe it, for the Son of God to be born. So he was born in a stable, and his bed was a feeding trough, the manger. And he was born in such a humble estate. I was thinking he left the glory of heaven and came to be born in the body of a child, and he grew up. And when Jesus Christ grew up, he died upon a cross for you and for me. That takes a lot of humility. That takes a tremendous love, a tremendous sacrifice for you and me. If you didn't receive anything else this Christmas, the most important gift that you could ever receive, if you have not yet received Jesus Christ, would be to personally receive Jesus Christ. God gives us his Son. It's like this. He offers us his Son, but his Son is not ours until we accept it. Have you ever had a gift that you wanted to give to someone, and for whatever reason they said, no, I won't accept the gift? Well, what they just did is they didn't accept you, the giver. Jesus Christ is God's gift to us. God the Father offers his Son to you and to me, and we have a choice to make, and the choice is to receive the Son or not. If we receive the Son, then we're not only receiving Jesus, but we're accepting the gift that God the Father has offered to us, his own Son, for us. So, this Christmas season, I encourage you to seriously examine your own heart and answer the question, am I observing Christmas for the right reason? That's to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, God's gift to us. Or am I focused on other things? If you're not focused on Jesus, you're not really celebrating Christmas. If you are celebrating Christmas in the right way, then you'll rejoice with me to say, praise God, the Son of God was born for you and for me. He gave his life for us. Now we have eternal life through faith in him.